Jonak. I'm back here with Mr. Orrin Woodward, and we just covered with you, the last time you saw us, was the first law of decline, which was Sturgeon's law, but it really wasn't a law of decline other than you have to be aware that it exists, and if the numbers aren't right, then you need to fix and adjust. But what would you call that law more of?
Sturgeon's law is more of the baseline. It's kind of telling you the scoreboard and letting you identify who your 10% and who your 90% are. Not from who you like or who you don't like, but from the scoreboard. Who's producing results? The guy who you might not like might be your top salesperson, and so they're producing results. So they're one of the 10%. There's no politics if you keep the scoreboard proper. And that's what Sturgeon's law ensures. You don't let politics get into your organization. If you haven't done a good job with Sturgeon's law, eventually you're going to promote the wrong person.
Right.
You're going to promote a sheep over the lions, and then you're in trouble.
Right. And that happens a lot.
All the time.
Because we do. Or say, for example, you've got two legs growing, just theoretically. And one's rocking. You know what we tend to naturally do? We tend to over-promote and congratulate and edify the person in the weak leg. But it's the 10%er here that actually should be recognized. Just what we kind of put edification where we want it to be. And if we use Sturgeon's law, we would know where to put it. So that's the baseline. Keep score, make sure Sturgeon's law is in place. What's the second law that you notice that says this is a universal law that applies to every organization that's growing or declining?
Bastiat's law is the second law.
Bastiat who?
Frederick Bastiat, okay. Named for a French economist of the 19th century again. And then what he noticed is it's within human nature to do the least amount of effort possible to get the required result. So in other words, if somebody has to labor, and if you have to have a job to make a living, you will work to make a living, be able to produce enough food for you and your family. But if someone will give you a free handout every day, man, you'll make it where it's almost a right, where I deserve a free handout. So if you're saying to your, in networking, for example, if you said, Art, you don't have to do anything. I'll show all your plans. I'll do all your contacting. I'll do everything for you.
Were you recording some of my conversations? I was guilty of that with a lot of the people I first started.
And if you give them that mindset, yeah. Then eventually they'll turn into victims because, hey, Art, I've tried to show a plan and you weren't there because you're trying to go serve somebody else. You can't possibly live up to that. And if you allow Bastiat's law to unleash in your organization, people start, you see envy, jealousy, people blaming, well, they got a special deal. How come they got, you went and showed two plans for that group. You didn't help me.
Right.
And you start seeing Bastiat's law unleashed. Now, in governments, how we talk about in leadership, you see that principle when people are given something without having to earn it. And then they can vote to bring that in. Well, you're going to see more and more people voting to be given a handout so that they don't have to work. And man, if you unleash Bastiat's law in society, then you've got certain people having a special deal and then other people getting a raw deal.
Right.
And that, and you watch every society that's ever declined, any network marketing organization that declines, Bastiat's law is all over it.
So if you look at the Roman Empire, Greek Empire, and then Orrin used the example of governments because most of you are familiar with that example. But you may not think that that doesn't apply to networking. Well, it does. You see, that is exactly what happens. And the human nature is to do the least amount you can to get by. So how do you, and you said jealousy and all these things that tend to destroy an organization, usually when you get to a certain point, the only person that can destroy an organization is the leader. He can bring it back out of orbit, so to speak, or out of gliding. He's the one by causing and ignoring Bastiat's law that it declines. So, one, when you build your group, can it sustain forever? It can, but it can decline. Let's accept the fact that groups can go up and down. How do you spot Bastiat's law? In a networking organization.
That's a great question. In network marketing, I would say the first thing that you would spot would be a special deals culture.
Okay.
Oh, this guy, he came in and he got a different deal than I, oh, he got placed in this spot and he got all this group and I didn't. And so people are like, well, this isn't a fair, equal playing field. And of course, the guy's like, well, if I have a choice of having to build two legs or being one given to me, well, it's going to be, you know, you've got to have a lot of character. You'd have to be part of that 10%
right.
to say, no, I don't want a special deal.
Sure.
Because you would understand that whether you got the special deal or someone else did, you're creating that where, well, everybody else is going to be looking for that special deal, and then you've got Bastiat's law turned loose in your organization. So to me, it's like when I'm creating a culture, I'm like, look, all of us get paid on the exact same circles, on the exact same numbers. as you perform, so shall you bonus. It wasn't because you knew me or you were such a big fish that you got a special deal. Because you think, oh, it's great, we got another big leader. But you just unleashed Bastiat's law in your organization. Right. How many times you see, oh, all these people came in, but then they're all gone. Why? Because you let Bastiat's law, it's like water going into a crack, freezing and opening up more. Eventually, you split the whole organization. The unity of that culture is gone if Bastiat's law is not checked.
And culture always wins. So you may have short-term gains, but if you're hurting your culture, then that's long-term loss.
And that's right.
And it sometimes can be devastating to the point where it's like, I don't know how to reel this back in. So that's one thing, favoritism or special, you know, privilege and so forth. What else would you see in an organization?
Power over people. If they can get to the point, you see it in government, if somebody gets in a position of power where he can take somebody else's production and figure out how to, you see it in governments where taxes keep going up, up and up. Why? Because they figure out the more I can tax my people, the more power I have, because money and power always go together.
Okay.
And so in a network marketing organization, Bastiat's law might be the owner figures out, it's easier just to try to tweak this compensation plan so more flows to me and less to the field.
Right.
But how many times have we seen in network marketing, man, if the owner ever starts trying to figure out how to tweak to benefit themselves, boy, that destroys the trust of that organization, and Bastiat's law destroys it.
Yeah, so that's, and it can be a leader as well. Sometimes you say, if this person rank advances, then I'm going to earn less. Or, you know, and you say, you got to help them rank advance. I mean, that's number one, let's help them. Or I've seen sabotage. If I can just help this person now go down in one rank, I'm going to get a bigger check. Or if I can discourage this guy to leave, then his organization rolls up to me. This is advanced stuff, but it's human nature.
Or if I can get this guy to leave that organization and come over and join me, because he's in a cross-line organization, and the company says, well, I'm just not going to get involved. No, if you allow injustice to where it's because it's easier to go steal somebody's 100 people leg than it is to go build your own, and if that behavior is not checked, you got Bastiat's law launched in your organization again.
And that can propagate and cause huge problems. And you may not have seen that happen in your organization yet, and some of you may have. The important part is be aware of it.
That's
be aware of Bastiat's law and seeing, again, restate the law one last time. Bastiat's law is...
People will do the least amount of work necessary to get the desired result. So if you told me I had to have 3 legs at the top of the chart, and I could either go build 100 people leg in order to do that, or I could go steal one of my neighbor's legs to do that, what do you think I'm going to do?
Right.
And so you see that within a company. You see that where people are raiding other companies to try to do that. And now all that behavior, it always, that gun kicks as much as it shoots.
Right.
And so to me, it's like the best policy, honesty and character, and go build. It might be a little bit more work up front, but when you build it, you've built those relationships, and people aren't coming in as hired guns and leaving as hired guns when somebody else gives a little more money.
Right. Okay. So that's Bastiat's law, and it applies to contests. You know, you run a contest, people hit exactly the amount they need to get that prize or that trip or whatever. So it can be used for good, for bad. Just understand that's human nature, and if you let it go run amok, then that can be very dangerous. So we're gonna be back in the next video, and we're gonna talk about the third law of decline, how to spot it, and then how to turn it around when you do.
In my mind.